Hi guys, I'm sysadmin SK. I am back today for the configuration of distributed switch in vCenter 7. So first I'll tell you my infrastructure. So I have an AD server with the OS of Windows 7.12 R2. Host name is dc01admin.local and the IP address is 172.16.01. I'll show you the current infrastructure. So if you go, you can see the computer name is DC01, domain is admin.local, firewall is off, IP address is 172.16.1, IP is enabled and everything is correct. So for the other, now I have three ESXi with me. I'll show you, this is my first ESXi, it's 172.16.0.3. I have a second ESXi which is 0.2, is 0.4 IP address. In 3 ESXi is 0.5 IP address, 172.16.0.5. And I have one storage server with me. I'll show you the storage server. This is my storage server. This is my ASCII storage server. Computer name is target.storage, admin.local domain name. And IP address is 0.172.16.0.20. So everything I'll show you, as you have seen the 3 SXi server, storage server, and using a subnet mask 255.0.0 and gateway is 172.16.0.1. And now I'll show you the vCenter server. So I'm accessing my vCenter server from my DC. So you can see this is my vCenter server. I have added 3 hosts. This is my data center. And if I'll show you the summary or a version of, you can see the version is 7, build number is this, 163.86.335. Last updated means last available installation date is the 10 July 2020 and file based backup has been scheduled. So everything is done. Now what we'll do, we'll go for the creation of distributed switch. For the creation of distributed switch, we have to go to the networking first. In networking, then click on data center, right click and distributed switch and new distributed switch. So we are creating new distributed switch. I'll give you the DS switch. This is the name. I'll give the admin central switch. Admin central switch. I'll go with the net. Version will be ESXi 7. If you have your older version, you can go with that, but I have all the higher versions, so I'm going with this ESX 7. Then we'll go uplink with before. The number of physical links you have, according to the number of physical links will assign the uplink. So we are taking as we have the 4 NICs, so we are going with the 4 uplink. And network IO control is enabled. I don't want to create a default port group, so I'll just deselect it. I'll next. Everything is done. Admin central switch is enabled. I'll go with the finish. So if I'll drop down this, I'll be getting one distributed switch created. You can see distributed switch has been created. Creation has been started. So we'll see completed. So we can see our distributed switch. You can see I have a distributed switch. So what I'll do, I'll go select and right click and we'll create a port group. So first port group will be management, MANAGEMENT, management port group. So this would be management port group. So I'll go with the next. Configuration I'll keep as a default. Elastic, static binding, 8 number of ports. Yes, default I wanted 8 port only. And this is a VLAN. I don't have VLAN, so I'll be keeping as a none. So I'll do the next and finish. So I have the one, I got management. For the second, I'll create code group for the storage. So I'll just create storage port group. I'll put the next number of ports default, static binding elastic, 8 number of ports default. I don't have a VLAN, so I'll be keeping none. Ready, finish, same. And third port group will create for the vMotion. So vMotion port group, I'll be putting next. I'll keep everything as default. I'll doing next and finish. And fourth, I'll create a port group for the VM. Which port group I'm going to assign to the VM, virtual machine to access. So VM port group, I'm giving the name as, I'll do the next. I'll keep everything as default. Next, finish. So now all the port group has been created. We'll just create on this. We'll go to the configure and go to the topology. So you can see I have a multiple port group, and if I'll select on it, it's connected. I'll click on it, is also connected, is also connected, is connected to all. So what I want is, I want to use only two port groups, two uplinks, not for all. So what I'm doing, I'm using only two uplinks. First two uplink I'm going to use, other four I'll keep for the future use. So what we can do is, so first thing, okay. So I'll go in the management. Okay, I'll just click on it and go to the edit setting and tuning and failover. So what I'll do, I'll select these two and I'll use, keep it unused. Means I'm going to use uplink 1 and uplink 2 for this. So I'll keep it, and everything I'll keep as default. Management port group, static binding, lastly in advance will block port is allowed, other will be disabled. If you have the VLAN you can put, I don't have it. In security is everything, every time it is rejected. In teaming and failover, which NIC you want to team and all. And route based originating virtual code, I'll keep the default. Link status only default. Notifier switch, yes. Failback, everything is there. If traffic shaping, if you want to give the bandwidth, you can keep the bandwidth, or you want that only this many bandwidth is defined. If you want to define the bandwidth, you can do from here. I'm not defining. If this is monitoring, is disabled. Miscellaneous will not do anything. So I'll put it okay. So then if I select this, see it is connected to only first report. Same thing I'll do for others. So I'll go for the edit settings. I'll go with the teaming and failover, and I'll make it to unused, and I'm using first two only. Same, it's getting configured. If I'll click on it, it is connected to first two only. Then I'll go to VM port group, I'll go to edit settings, again I'll go to the teaming and failover. I'll make it unmute, okay, and I'll do first two uplinks, which is configured. I'll go for the vMotion, edit settings. You have to follow this step before doing the main configuration. So this is the process how you can go for the distributed switch configuration in your UAT infrastructure or in a production infrastructure. So it's loading, yes, it's loaded. I'll go with the teaming and failover, and I'll do it. If you want use four or all four, you can. If you want for the keep in a standby, you can, but I'm not keeping. I'm just using only two as a team. So I'll be doing okay. Now I'll show you everything is connected to first report only, you can see. And if I'll show you for the virtual machine, it is also connected to first report. If I'll go for the last one, it is also connected to two, connected to first two port. You can see, so it is connected to first two port. Now what we'll do, well, we'll right click and we'll go for the add and manage host. We'll add the all the hosts. So we'll go for the next, click on the host, how many hosts you want to add in this switch. I'm adding all the three, so I'll go with OK, added. I'll go with the next, so it will show manage physical. Here we'll assign the uplink. Loading, sometimes it takes time, sometimes not. Wait till it comes, but you have to follow this process to get the this is the straight process where you will not getting any problem. So you see, we have the four mix everywhere. Okay, so in last also, if you will go, you have four mix. So what we do, we'll use first two mix, VM mix 1. We'll click right click, assign uplink, select first, and we'll assign uplink as an uplink 1. Okay, in second, we'll assign uplink 2. Okay, same for other also. We have done with first, so we'll just make it upper, and for the second again, we'll go for the assign uplink 1, we'll go OK, and we'll assign uplink 2, OK, it's done, we'll make it up arrow. In the third again, we'll just select and we'll assign the uplink, link 1, and in VM 1, assign uplink 2. Okay, so we have assigned the uplinks to all, so we'll make it up arrow, just go next. Here we'll keep everything as a default, we'll not do anything to, we'll not touch to anything, everything is okay, we'll just go next, we'll go the next, we'll go the finish. So, now distributed switch has been created. So you can see, we have like this, we have created our infrastructure. If you go here, you can see we have done with the infrastructure. We'll go to the configure option. I'll show you in configure option, VM kernel adapter. So if we select on it, you can see everything is done. We have added the management network, physical adapter. We'll go to the physical adapter. You can see we have added both the physical adapter to the system. As same, you can configure your distributed switch. It's all about creating a distributed switch over the vCenter 7. This is all about, you can do in v6.5 also, 6.7 also, and 7 also. In every version, creating a distributed switch is same as we have done. So we have created a distributed switch. In the next lecture, I'll show you how you can configure a storage adapter at this. So for this, we'll stop.